In this podcast, we'll give you an insight into the new features of EDIUS 10.20. Background file conversion, H.264/AVC file export with NVIDIA GPU, Job Monitor tab, ProRes RAW color space selection, MP3 audio file export, MINK update. In EDIUS, it's possible to convert files directly in the bin window. In version 10.20, conversions of single or multiple files take place in the background. This allows you to convert files while continuing to work on your project. With version 10.20, the selection of formats available for conversion has been considerably expanded. There are different scenarios where a file conversion makes sense. With a single file conversion, all available export formats are possible. If, for example, you have a file which is difficult to handle, such as RAW or H.265, you can convert it according to your needs. If you need the file to run smoothly on your computer, you could convert it into Grass Valley HQX. If you want to run the file on a smart TV, tablet, or media player, we recommend H.264/AVC. For the conversion of multiple files, EDIUS 10 version 10.20 has extended the list of intermediate codecs you can choose, such as Apple ProRes. EDIUS Workgroup offers DNxHD in addition. EDIUS supports almost every video format on the market, while other software doesn't. So a batch conversion in the background will allow you to use footage in different software, or even a professional media player such as HyperDeck, Ninja, or Shogun. When converting, you can not only change the file format or codec, you can even change parameters like resolution, frame rate, aspect ratio, and so on. To start a conversion, right-click on one or multiple files in the bin window and select Convert. Here, you have three options: File, File Batch, or Alpha Mat. So, you can convert a single file, all selected files, or even create files with alpha information such as ProRes 4444. The details of the output format are set in the Export dialog. The created jobs can be viewed in the GV Job Monitor. If you double-click on the converting file, the new job window will open. Here too, you can see the progress of the conversion, as well as on the clip thumbnail in the bin. When the clip is converting, the file in the bin window turns green. When paused, the color changes to yellow. If the conversion fails, the clip turns red. A conversion can fail for various reasons, for example, if the source file is damaged. When the job is completed, it will be displayed as an online clip. The color indicator on the thumbnail in the bin window also applies to a normal export in EDIUS 10 version 10.20. In the export window, the button Add to Bin is integrated. So the clip will automatically be added to the bin window after export. The same function is available for batch exports. H.264/AVC file export with NVIDIA GPU. Version EDIUS 10 10.20 now offers broader GPU hardware support to encode H.264. Besides software encoding, QuickSync and compatible NVIDIA GPUs can now be used to encode H.264. The H.264 NVIDIA encoder lets you choose between superfine or normal quality. Please note that interlace and 10-bit cannot be output. We recommend H.265 to output a small file in 10-bit. You will find a list of NVIDIA GPUs capable of encoding H.264 in the description below this video. If your card works with H.265, it also works with H.264. But even older cards, like the popular GeForce GTX 750 and 950 to 980 GPUs support H.264 encoding. Job Monitor tab. As we have seen before, in version 10.20, the Job Monitor will open if you double-click on a converting or exporting file in the bin window. But you can also integrate the Job Monitor as a tab into the EDIUS layout. Open the Job palette and place the Job Monitor according to your wishes. However, you can still access the Job Monitor via the Tool menu as well. The new Job Monitor has extended options. As every background job in EDIUS 10 is monitored in the Job Monitor, you can now select display types such as export, batch export, waveform cache, proxy, convert file, partial rendering, and clip rendering. There is also a search function integrated, and you can show a file directly in the Windows Explorer via right-click. ProRes RAW Color Space Selection. With a growing number of cameras that support ProRes RAW, there are also more different color spaces. EDIUS 10 10.20 now automatically detects the correct color space when importing ProRes RAW footage. The necessary information is retrieved from the metadata. If there is no metadata, BT2020 BT2100 HLG is chosen. The color space setting for clips from older versions is preserved. The color space can be changed manually via the clip properties. MP3 file export. In EDIUS 10 10.20, it's now possible to export MP3 audio files. Mink update. EDIUS 10 10.20 offers new features in Mink as well. Before you import footage from a hard drive into Mink, you can now disable the import settings pane. Usually, detailed information will be displayed above the clip, such as capacity of the storage location and metadata of the imported clip. If you wish to disable this information, simply go to Settings, Import. On the bottom, you will see the checkbox labeled Hide. Activate this option so the information on top of the clip can be hidden. Version 10.20 in Mink also offers you more options to export your timeline. Besides H.264 and H.265, you can also now export your storyboard in Grass Valley HQX and Apple ProRes. Click here for the next podcast. To subscribe to our YouTube channel, click here. You can find more tips and tricks in our EDIUS podcast. Visit EDIUS.net for more information about EDIUS, plugins, tutorials, and the latest downloads.